conditions.
Hurricane Andrew continues to be a very, very strong and potent hurricane. We can take a look at the latest particulars on it. Here is a good sign. The central pressure over the last 3 or 4 hours has stopped dropping, so that might show us that the storm has reached its maximum intensity, but still it is a very strong storm at 150 miles an hour on the Saffir-Simpson scale, where 5 is the most powerful hurricane. This is just very, very close to being a powerful hurricane, a 5 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. Continues its general movement due west, heading toward the southern coast of Florida. And at its current movement, it would put it right near the Miami area tomorrow morning, sometime around 4 or 5 in the morning. That is the center of the storm. Already by midnight, they're going to start feeling the hurricane force winds along the coast of Miami. So a very potent storm, to say the least. Where you see the orange on this map, there are not only tropical storm warnings, but hurricane watches. The area shaded in red, hurricane warnings. That means if you haven't taken your precautions already, you need to in a hurry. As we take a look at the latest strike probabilities, looks like the general movement is going to be toward the west. So the highest probability of the storm passing within, the center of the storm passing within 60 nautical miles of any one place is those areas that are shaded in red. So South Florida is the area that's going to get hit by this major hurricane. Storm surge expected to be between 10 and 14 feet across the Bahama Islands. Looks like it will cross the island of Eleuthera, and the storm surge there could be as high as 18 feet in the Bahamas. So some nasty conditions there. Generally, a 7 to 10 foot storm surge expected across South Florida, but in the Bay of Biscayne, it could be higher than that, some 9 to 13 feet. Tropical storm force winds extend out as far as 105 miles. From the center of this storm, hurricane-forced winds almost as far as 50 miles from the center of the storm. The enhanced satellite picture, that shows you the higher and colder cloud tops, showing you a very concentric, well-organized hurricane continuing to move due west, right toward the southern coast of Florida. Again, if you haven't taken precautions, you need to do it as quick as possible and evacuate as quick as possible. Already getting a few feeder bands. Winds along the coast now are gusting as high as 30 miles an hour. They'll continue to slowly increase. Probably around midnight, they'll really be picking up, getting close to tropical storm force. Outside of Andrew itself, not too much else to worry about in the tropics. Lester bringing heavy rains to Arizona. Some spots already 3 inches, could be ending up with some spots getting 8 inches. So Lester causing problems in the southwest with heavy rain and flash flooding in this part of the country. So two storms to deal with. Here's a look at where your tropical storm warnings are in effect right now around the Baja of California. The moisture feeding into the southwest. Expect a lot of heavy rain here and some local flooding. More on Andrew and the national weather coming up.